unlimited. Your future is unlimited.
Ever since she burst onto the local theatre scene back in 2010, Stephanie Van Driessen has been wowing audiences with her engaging performances. From dazzling musicals such as Cabaret and The Secret Life of Nora, to dramatic plays like Betrayal, as well as singing with the Malaysian Philharmonic Orchestra in Ola Bola in concert, the 34-year-old triple threat has been hungry to develop her talents even further. Last year, the award-winning Malaysian artist managed to crowdsource funds to continue her MFA in acting studies at the prestigious East 15 Acting School in Lowton, Essex, all the way in the UK. Currently on a break in Malaysia before she goes back to complete her two-year course next year, Van Driessen will be busy channeling the knowledge she's acquired at the institution that has been endorsed by the likes of Sir Ben Kingsley and Colin Firth.
Okay, great. So the first workshop that I'm actually doing is the last week of July, and it's going to be at Bentley Music Academy. It's a two-day workshop, but actually it's separate for the kids as well as for adults. And what it's all about, I really want to help people open up their voices a lot more, because we're quite shy as a society, you know, we're quite soft-spoken, and it's just all about opening up expression. So I have one called No Fear Singing, and that's where I'm going to be taking people through basic exercises for singing, but also if they're already singers, I just want to help them open up their voices a lot more and speak and sing confidently. So that's the first one. And the second one that I'm doing is mostly on musical theater singing. So it's going to be, we're going to be working on the format of musical theater. And I mean, it's quite, in a way, people like musical theater here, but also there's a lot of story through the songs. So I want people to connect with that. And with my 10 years of experience as a musical theater performer, as well as now being in London and learning from the best, I just felt it was natural for me to come and share the knowledge here. And also this higher wisdom, I guess you could call it, but techniques with you know, the local community here, as well as people in general who want to explore their voices. I do, but it's in London. yeah. I mean, I was kind of thinking, like, you know, I was trying to maybe book a gig or something. I mean, I've sung for gigs. I still do that. It was more corporate. But as far as a public performance, I did think about it, but it was just not enough time to put together something really quality, you know, aside from maybe just doing like a one-off at a, you know, Gaslight or something. You know me, I like to impact a bit. So so I was like, if I'm going to do it, I want to make sure it's really good. So I have plans, like next year when I come back, I'm going to really do something quite big and, you know, make sure that I have that whole year to prepare for it. So it'll be a showcase. But for now, I'm training. I've been really coming back. It's been lovely to teach and also do these workshops, because I feel we are lacking in that, in the education part of the arts. And I'm just so fortunate to be able to go all the way there and experience that level of training. So I feel like I'm here at this time now to help people to get to the next level, whatever that is, even if they're like beginners getting to intermediate, or just someone who has a problem, you know, just expressing themselves. So yeah, and I'm feeling really good about it. So long-term goals. I actually looking at making London a base that I can work from. It just feels that at least for the next 5 years, 5 or 6 years, I mean, why not? You know, you go all the way there and there is all this potential, you know. I mean, I know it's hard, but it's a challenge, you know, it's a chance to grow. And I feel that that's just the perfect place in order to either, you know, go for the West End, but also they have very strong ties to the TV and film industries as well, in London as well as in the States. So it just, it's like the right location for me to go all out and see how far, you know, I can reach. And at the same time also, I will be traveling with this work, so I will be giving these workshops and all that, developing further to a global audience. Long-term plan, big, you know, let's conquer London, let's conquer, you know, if we can film, we do film, things like that. When I go to London, I'm actually doing a short film that is going to be pitched also to a lot of these larger networks like Netflix and all that. So it's just lovely to be able to work where that's possible. So, and then I'll come back and, you know, help to establish certain things here. So more of a, like a global positioning if I can, yeah.